Just arrived?
Yeah. We're looking for 5048 and a half.
Sit down, Coop. A nice cozy little place with an extra wall bed. But it's 55 and a half.
No, you don't understand. We're looking for Mr. Spartan.
Spartan? Of all people!
Does he work at night?
No, but you see, Willie's,
Come on, Bob. Let's go wake him. Bob, you leave the landing.
Okay. First trip to California?
Yeah.
Mighty pretty country.
Sure is. I suppose you're a native son.
Yep. Too much of it. Burns up the grass.
Hey, where's the big shot anyway? Can a fella have a few words with this
director?
A director?
An assistant director.
Well, how long has it been since you've had a call from the studio?
6 weeks.
Of course, I have to prepare for my next assignment.
Any reason why you shouldn't be earning a living?
No, of course not, but...
I say, listen, you better come along with me. We'll hire a car and take a look at some of those farms.
But, Bob, the phone!
Well, if you haven't had a call from the studio for 6 weeks, I think maybe you can take an afternoon off.
But... Hello? This is Willie Barton speaking. Oh, Mr. Brown. All right, Mr. Brown. I'll have Mother... I'll speak to her about it. I said I'd speak to her about it. All right, Mr. Brown. I will have Mother send it over to you right away. Thank you, Mr. Brown. How is Mr. Brown?
Who's Mr. Brown?
Why, he's the grocery man.
What does he want sent over?
We forgot to pay.
You forgot to? What's the matter? Didn't you get my check this month?
Why, yes, of course, Bob. But Willie needed a new pair of riding boots.
Riding boots? I send money out here every month for food and rent, and you spend it on riding boots for him. Huh. Well, that settles,
Bob. You yell.
I yell if I want to. Young man, you come along with me. Never mind. I'll answer. Probably the butcher. Hello? Well, no, this is his brother-in-law.
I have to search for a minute to tell you that the big scene comes off tomorrow. And if you get down here right away, you might get on to help handle the crowd.
All right, I'll be right down.
That's fine, Willie. But hurry. Goodbye.
All right, I won't quibble then. Let's say $100 a day. Okay, goodbye. Sorry, Bob, I can't go with you. I'll help you out some other time.
Yeah, well, don't forget your riding boots.
Oh, think of it. $100 a day. Isn't it exciting?
I'll be able to control myself until I see that $100. Say, come on, get your hat on. We're going to look at some of those farms.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bob. I've got a terrible headache.
Well, let you and I go, Mother, huh?
I'd like to, but I've got to cook Willie's dinner.
Say, what's the matter with everybody, huh? Oh, I got to go by myself. Well, you people should feel right at home on a nut farm.
But you had a headache. I have, but I think the air will do me good.
Air? That Bob was right.
The school racket's all right, but if some pupils don't turn up soon, I'll have to go back waiting tables at the embassy.
I don't know what excuse I'm going to give my hotel. I've exhausted all the old ones.
When will you boys realize that it's always darkest just before the dawn? Any moment, opportunity may knock.
Who's that?
Opportunity.
No, opportunity only knocks once. Come in.
Are you Hamilton T. Holland?
Yes, what can I do for you?
We're from the Globe Furniture Company.
Wait a minute. Just a minute. I was willing. I'll settle this. Just a moment.
Hi, Joe.
Hello. Globe Furniture Company? This is Hamilton G. Holland speaking. Yes. A couple of men who claim to be from your office are here to remove my furniture. Now, I should think you would apologize. And in the meantime, cancel that other order of mine. Where are you going with that?
I'm taking it in. You know, it's been disconnected for 3 days.
Right, Joe. And cancel that other order of mine.
strictly modern desk. Something with a dash and a verve.
Sure, we'll bring you back one with walnut trimming.
And don't forget the glass top. I hope you'll forgive the condition of my office as we're having them redecorated. Will you come in and meet my associates? This is Mr. Van Norton, one of my graduates.
Charmed, Miss...
Mrs. Bent. Mrs. Robert Bent.
And this is Mr. Philippert, my scenario writer.
How do you do?
Delighted.
I saw your ad in the magazine.
Oh, the ad. So you decided to follow in the footsteps of Pickford, Swanson, Garbo, and Mae West?
Well, yes, that is I.
Exactly. Have you been in California long, Mrs. Bent?
Oh, no. We just arrived. My husband sold his business in Newark, and we've decided to settle here.
And a very wise decision. This is the land of opportunity. Won't you sit down, Mrs. Bent? Now, of course, about your picture possibilities. Of course, you understand we're only interested in pupils who possess exceptional qualifications.
Yes, that is right.
What experience have you had, Mrs. Bent?
Well, you see,
Have you been on the stage?
Oh, yes. I played the lead in the charity show our bridge club gave, and, of course, in college,
Well, then, you're not unfamiliar with the traditions of the theater.
Oh, no.
But, gentlemen. My associates seem a little undecided, Mrs. Bent. So I suggest that we make a test under regular studio conditions. You don't object, do you, Mrs. Bent?
Oh, not at all, Mr. Holland. I only hope I'll make good.
Will you gentlemen see that everything is in readiness on the stage?
Well, certainly, Mr. Holland.
Thank you, sir. Of course, you understand that this will be simply a photographic test. Just to see whether or not you have that elusive something that is so necessary to motion picture greatness.
Oh, I hope so, Mr. Holland. I'll do my best.
Don't worry. I have a feeling everything will be all right.
Hey, where are you going with the camera?
I'm going to trade it in for a ham sandwich.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Joe. You got to help us out. Holland's got a live prospect, and he wants to give it a test build-up.
He's out of luck. We haven't any film.
Oh, we don't need any.
Oh, he owes me 2 weeks' salary now.
But I tell you, here's a chance to get your money. Holland has a sucker. I mean a client. Come on, ask Van.
All right. Are you sure this is real dough?
This is the real old-fashioned stuff.
What do you say, Joe?
What you been with? All right. Come on, now, boys. Get it all set up.
Yeah. We'll go. Come on.
Just be completely at ease, Mrs. Bent. I want you to feel perfectly at home. Just relax. Mrs. Bent, would you mind standing for just a moment while we make a few adjustments? Is this position all right for you, Joe? I want Mrs. Bent to have every assistance we can give her for this very important test.
That's about right.
Splendid. Now, you just relax, Mrs. Bent, while we arrange the lights. Take it easy, Mrs. Ben, but give it all you've got. The camera ready?
Okay.
All right, camera. Now, Mrs. Ben, turn your head slowly to the right. Now, to the left, slowly. Way around, we want to get both profiles. That's it. Now, face the camera, smile. No, you're happy. That's it. Now you look just a little to your right. You see your lover approaching down the lane. You're very happy to see him wave. You see a woman with him. You're jealous. You're angry. You're very angry. You feel as though you could kill her. And suddenly you realize it's his arm. Hey,
juice off on us.
Congratulations, Mrs. Bent. A perfect fade-out to a lovely scene. I'm sure the film will justify my reactions. I'm seldom mistaken.
Then you'll take me?
Walked into my office, I pinned my paper. You're progressing much faster than I'd even hoped. And since seeing your last test, I'm convinced that you're possessed of the divine fire. You're now ready to scale the heights.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Is that all for you?
Oh, Mr. Holland.
I suppose so. But I prefer to ignore business while we're at luncheon.
Why don't you answer it? It might be important.
Oh, boy.
Working hard on this one.
Boy, is she a lifesaver. Very soon I hope to see your name in electric lights. The star of your first picture.
How much do you think it's going to cost to make this picture?
Well, under careful supervision, which of course I shall bring, I should say it can be done for approximately 40,000. So that's the amount that you're... that's the amount you said we could figure out. I speak to your husband.
Well, I could bring him to the studio this afternoon.
Then. Wait up.
Here, let me pay it. For good luck.
Oh, now, please.
Oh, no, no. Everything now must be done the business way. You can take me to lunch tomorrow.
Mom, you noticed a change in Helen in the past 2 weeks?
Well, yes, I have.
Yeah? What have you noticed?
She's getting terribly extravagant, buying all those new clothes and doodads.
Are they the kind of clothes she'll be using on a farm? Not in a million years, they're not. Listen, Helen's been bitten by a bug. The motion picture bug. Yeah, that ain't all. The man after her.
You mean to say that Helen's been running around with another man?
No, not exactly a man. Listen, he's one of the slickest fakes in the motion picture business. If we don't do something about it, he'll be talking Helen into investing Bob's money.
Oh, you frighten me. That would be terrible.
Something's got to be done.
Hello there. Anybody home?
And done quick.
Running around with another man. How do you know?
I've seen him together dozens of times on a boulevard. His name is Holland and he's a fake and he's...
Where is this farm, Mr. Bent?
Oh, down in Pecano Valley. It's a nut farm.
Taking Willie with you? That's a good one, ain't it? Like to be a looking place. How many acres?
50.
Sure is.
Sure is what?
Nifty. That's quite a house.
Yes, it's lovely.
Yes, she is. You think your wife will like it?
The nearest neighbor is 5 miles away.
Yeah, we won't be bothered with having people run in on us all the time.
The neighbors will have to drive over.
Yeah.
Is that something new?
Oh, yes, that's my wife's latest photograph.
Looks like your wife. She's pretty, ain't she? Ought to be in a movie.
Can't something be done about this?
I could speak to a friend of mine.
Thanks.
Oh, no trouble at all. Always glad to give advice about a farm. I know land from here to enter.
He can hear pretty well when you don't want him to.
Goodbye. Don't mind me. Little hard of hearing.
Bye, Mr. Sliscom.
Bob, I hope you haven't offended Mr. Sliscom. I wish you'd be more careful.
Careful? My wife's running around with another man, and you ask me to be careful.
Oh, Bob, she's up against a racket she doesn't know anything about.
Now, shut up.
You better buy that farm.
What are you running around with this man Holland for?
What do you mean, running around with him?
Why, you've been running around with him. Well, I've been looking for a home for him.
Why, Bob Benson, I never heard of such a thing. Oh.
Don't let the waterway catch you, Bob.
I want this nonsense stopped. One moving picture nut in the family is enough. I happen to know this man Holland's reputation, and he's a crook. And Norrie's naked woman would be seen on the street with him.
This is some of your doing. What have you been telling Bob?
I mean, but the truth, sister. Why, Holland will have Bob's money inside of a month. Then Bob will be broke. Broke in California. And if there's one state in the world worse than any other to go broken, it's California.
Come on over here. I want to show you some pictures. Oh, don't cry. Come on, sit down. I want to show you something. Hey, look here. Here are the pictures of the farm I found.
You wouldn't even look at my pictures.
Why, yes, I did. Why, I thought they were beautiful.
Honestly?
Of course. Here's a picture of the house. Isn't that a beauty?
Well, where are the other houses? The neighbors' houses?
Well, there aren't any near neighbors. We'll be all by ourselves. Wouldn't that be great?
Yes, I suppose so.
And we'll be independent for life. The owner showed me his figures for last year, and he cleared over $5,000.
Oh, but that's nothing compared to what Mr. Holland said I could make. But I suppose that's all over now.
Attic. We have time to close the deal this afternoon. What do you say?
All right. Oh, but I thought...
Gee, honey. We're going to be awfully happy up there in the mountains. Away from everybody.
Away from everybody?
Yeah. And at night, when the stars are out, why, it's so still...
from Hollywood?
Oh, long way.
Is it near a railroad?
No, no. But sometimes when the wind's in the right direction, you can hear the train whistle. Way off.
Oh.
Oh, gee, honey. You're going to love this place. Way at night, after the sun is down, you can hear the wild animals howling.
Wild animals?
Oh, just the sort of place I've been dreaming of for years.
Oh. Bob, you've always let me do what I wanted to before.
Well, I do it now if I thought it was the right thing to do. Of course, I never had a great opinion of Willie, but I think he knows what he's talking about this time.
Bob, the studio's only 5 minutes from here.
Yeah, but the real estate office closes in a...
Oh, but it's right on our way, Bob. And it'll only take us a few minutes to see the test. Bob, if they find out that we're not going to do the picture, they'll destroy the test. Oh, and I wanted so to have you see it.
Oh, no, please, honey. Don't coax me.
No. I wouldn't have you do anything you don't want to do.
Just because you look like a famous star doesn't even work for nothing.
Say, listen, what do you suppose I got this furniture and set the stage for? You'll get paid. Now, this client will be here any minute now. All I want is the old routine.
You'll get the old... Anyway, but a girl's got to live. Oh, why talk about it? After all,
I'll get my pay this time. Be the last time you see me around this joint.
I don't see how I could possibly do it for $100,000, but of course, if Mr. Holland says so. Oh, I certainly would take Mr. Holland's advice. Do you remember that extra $50,000 he got me on my last contract?
There's a chair, dear.
Pardon me for staring, but there's something about you which reminds me of my sister.
Oh. Hey, John, have you got a cigarette?
No, May, but perhaps this gentleman has one.
Yes.
I go home.
Oh, now don't say that, Greta. We'll sign the contracts in the morning.
Oh.
Well, Mrs. Vance, I'm so sorry to have kept you waiting.
Oh, that's all right, Mr. Holland. I want you to know my husband. He's come to see my test.
How do you do, Mr. Vance? How do you do, Mr. Holland? Well, won't you come in?
Oh, thank you.
It'll take the operator a few minutes to get the film ready, and then we'll go into projection.
Oh, we had a few minutes, haven't we, Bob? Haven't we, Bob?
Huh? Oh, yes.
What I mean?
Now that you mention it, I do. It's remarkable.
Say, what's all this about?
Mr. Dent, you're a very lucky man.
Why?
Didn't anyone ever tell you that you look like Adolf Martin?
I'm glad to see you get off the hook. That haul would take the gold out of your teeth. What a racket. And just think, some of those nitwits fall for it.
Oh, boy, is he quick.
I had one half of his line of talk and licked the world.
Hey, what do you know about the picture business?
All you do is to sit around and talk. If you knew one-tenth as much as you think you do, you'd be drawing down a salary instead of sitting around here criticizing people.
Bob, please.
If I want to put my money, you understand, not yours. If I want to invest in a business that I believe is going to pay big profits, I'm going to do it without any advice from you.
Then you didn't buy the farm?
No. I've been shown some figures in Mr. Holland's office, figures to prove what he says. He let me in for 50%.
Yeah, for $40,000. So, you got in your dirty work, didn't you?
And that's a fine thing for you to say to your sister.
That's a fine thing for my sister to do to her husband.
Boys, please. Mr.
Griffith's
coming tonight to read us a story.
Oh, I give up. Now listen. Remember, when you're down and out and you're broke and you haven't got a cent and you're living in hall bedrooms, don't come to me.
Oh, Willie, where are you going?
I'm leaving this house for good.
Good.
Oh, never mind. Sit down. He'll be back as soon as it's time to eat again.
What's the problem around here someplace? What was the name of it?
Scorching Passion. You know, the one about the desert, the foreign legion.
Great grief. Are we going to start making that picture again?
We are. We can find the script.
I remember most of it.
You remembered most of it when you first wrote it.
Wait a minute. What's this?
Sorry, Biddy. I forgot about your hay fever.
It's not hay fever, I tell you.
It's the echo of a summer cold.
Well,
where's the... Masterpiece. I'm going to hike over there now while the deal's hot. You fellas put a new cover on it. I'll see you over at the vent bungalow.
Don't forget, tonight we're addressing.
How do you do? Is this Mr. Vent's house?
Yes.
Is he at home?
No, he's just gone down to the corner to get some cigars. Won't you come in?
Thank you.
I'm Mrs. Vent's mother.
I'd have known it if I'd met you in a crowd. You resemble your very attractive daughter.
Oh, you think so?
Oh, decidedly. Mrs.
Barton.
Barton? She was a very famous actress by that name. Her home was in Trenton. Or was it in Newark?
Newark? I used to live in Newark. I don't remember hearing about her.
She died a great many years ago. Wouldn't it be strange if your daughter inherited her talent? Beauty. Beauty. She reminds me of... Now, don't tell me.
Marion Davies.
That. Only your daughter's eyes have a deeper fire.
She takes a nice picture, doesn't she?
Mrs. Barton, your daughter is a very beautiful woman. I see a great resemblance.
And won't you sit down?
Thank you. I've just driven in for my farm. I'm a trifle tired.
Oh, you own a farm?
I own three. All purchased with a profit. A huge profit of the motion picture business.
Oh. You're the moving picture man?
Yes. Hamilton T. Holland. I see your daughter has been telling you about it.
No, my son has told me about
you. Oh. Oh, your son. See, his name is...
Willie.
Of course, Willie Barton. Oh, you're a talented boy.
What?
He's destined to make a great name for himself. I've had my eye on him for some time.
Is that so?
Mrs. Barton, you should be a very proud woman. To be the mother of two such talented children.
But Willie tells me that you...
Your son doesn't understand me. Being misunderstood is bitter misfortune of every great producer.
Dear, I wish Willie was here.
Oh,
listen to me. They think I'm a false alarm.
Willie, you must do something to stop them.
Or you think I'm a false alarm too, huh?
If you go away tonight without making one final effort, yes. Take me in your strong arms once more, mistress.
What?
I didn't say anything. I'll be waiting here, mistress. And should you never return, I'll go on. But on. But on. Willie, you can't go now.
That's right. If they think I'm a false alarm, wait till they see me in action.
And of course. Maybe Jack can help us.
That's an idea. He's a hard-headed businessman. Bring him along.
Goodbye, Eustace. Goodbye.
Who is this Eustace?
He's my lover in the picture. He just left me to ride across the burning desert. A year rolls by.
And you're back in Newark.
No city. Cairo. I see the camels coming across the desert. I walk.
A mile.
Marty, you don't know the story. Mr. Bitterford said there's a smash at the end of it.
You bet there is. For Bob and his 40,000.
No such thing. Why, the money Bob's going to make out of this picture?
Because I'm putting a flea's eye.
Why are you so obstinate? Do you think you know more than Mr. Holland?
Yes.
I walk. And walk.
And so, Mrs. Barton, I'm looking forward to making a lot of money. For all of us.
Yes.
And I feel...
Willie, what brought you back?
I changed my mind.
You know, Mr. Holland.
Yeah, I know.
How do you do, Willie?
Have you seen your sister?
Yeah. She's out in the garden rehearsing her primitive emotions. I love you. I hate you. Take back your jewels. I scorn you, other man. All your advances. I'm through. I'm through, I'm through, I'm through, I tell you. I don't know what I'm saying. Take me back. Take me back.
Willie, Barton, have you gone crazy?
I got in the garden to get a load of her.
That's exactly.
I always wanted
to. That's lovely. Rick, you ought to be ashamed of yourself making fun of your sister.
What has he told you to?
Willie doesn't realize that his sister possesses the divine.
And her husband possesses $40,000.
Did you know that there was a great actress in Europe by the name of Barton?
What have they got to do with the noise in the garden?
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Holland?
How do you?
I hope you don't mind Willie's playfulness.
Not at all. Your mother and I were enjoying the performance.
Come on in, gentlemen.
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Bitterford?
How do you do, Mrs. Ben?
And Mr. Van Norden.
I met these gentlemen outside.
Did you bring the story, Mr. Bitterford?
Oh, yes, indeed, Mrs. Van.
Mother dear, I want you to meet Mr. Bitterford, the author.
How do you do?
And Mr. Van Norden, my leading man.
So you're back, eh?
Yes, Mother.
I didn't think you had the gumption to go through with it.
That remains to be seen.
Now, what's all this? Quite comfortable. Mr. Bitterford, you sit right here, please.
Thank you.
Where the light will fall over your shoulders.
Maybe it would be better if it would fall on his head.
Oh, no. No, it's much better over the shoulder. And, Mr. Van Norden.
Oh, if you don't mind, I'll just sit over here.
Oh, all right. And, Mother, will you sit here next to Mr. Bitterford, please? And Mr. Holland, next to my mother, please.
Thanks.
Over there, please.
Oh,
yes. Well, I guess we're all ready now.
The action begins in a small country village.
Oh, Mother, will you answer that, please? Oh, how do you do, Mrs. Smith?
Hello,
Angela. Come right in.
Thank you.
This is Mr. Van Norden, Helen's leading man. This is Mrs. Siskin and his daughter, Agatha. Mr. Siskin's our landlord. He owns this bungalow court.
Play Agatha's picture.
Oh.
Funny, I never seen one before.
Mr. Biddison. Mr. Biddison's an officer. And this is Mr. Holland.
Well, come right in, sir. We're very glad to have you.
Thank you.
We're just about to hear Helen's new play.
Well, we've got the time.
Well, I think we're ready to proceed, don't you?
Yes, let's do.
The action begins in a small country village.
Huh?
It is about 7 of a bright spring morning. The village lads are driving the cows to pasture.
What time do you say?
About 7 in the morning.
Why?
To make their cows go 3 hours. 4 o'clock in the morning is the time we drive cows to pasture. Is that so, Mr. Holland?
Well, of course.
Change the time to 4 o'clock.
Oh, all right.
Begin again, Mr. Biddeford.
It is about 7 in the morning.
There's another thing. Village lads don't drive cows to pasture. It's country boys.
Of course. What's the matter with you, Biddeford?
I'll change the first seat. After the cows are in the pasture, useless, that's the hero. Leap smart. Molly carries a tail on her arm. She's on her way to pick wild blackberries.
Pick what?
Wild blackberries. In the spring?
Better make it in autumn.
It has to be in the spring.
Then cut out the blackberries. Make it dandelion green.
Or spinach.
Nice dandelion green for helping. Blackberries give you a bellyache.
Mr. Smith, we're going to begin again. Please be quiet.
That fellow's got hay fever. I have not got hay fever. That's what I said, mister. Hay fever.
All right. Can I get you a little spirits of ammonia?
Oh, not pneumonia. Hay fever.
It's not hay. Hey,
you're too tight. That golden rod does that.
Well, let's remove it.
From the beginning.
Well, the action begins in a small country village. It is about 7. And in 4 of a bright spring morning. The village, I mean the country boys, are driving the cows to the pasture. And across the desert.
Hold on. I'm not understanding. You've been over an hour reading.
Cut the cattle.
What? The cattle.
The cattle.
Camels.
Camels. Carries the foreign lady to the rescue. Then he takes her in his arms and his face.
Well, now, that's a right pretty story. How much did you say this picture was to cost?
$40,000.
Make a better one for 50?
Listen, if you're the type of hard-boiled businessman I like to meet, why, for $10,000 more, we can make this not merely a picture, but an epic. Epic.
Good idea.
Here, hon. This would be my proposition. Now, I just thought I'd like to be in on it.
Of course, if you object, now, gentlemen, please, I'm sure we can make a satisfactory agreement. For $40,000, we're assured of a comfortable profit. What if, by a method system, simply investing $10,000 more, we can double our own profit? Good business, seems to say, do it.
Yes. Sounds reasonable.
Then, gentlemen, I'll have to change this contract to read 40% to you, and 15% to Mr. Clifton, and 45% to the Holland Production. The gentlemen, we just initial these changes.
Yes. It's there. You're not going to go through with this.
Oh, Mrs. Listen, you ought to know better. I guess I'll tell you.
Yes, Dad.
Oh, honey, you just keep out of it. Bob, you're not going to throw your money away like this, are you?
Just a moment, gentlemen. I have a very pleasant surprise that I've been saving until the signing of this contract. Now, as you know, a great deal of the success of the picture will depend upon the director.
Well, I've had a certain young man under observation for quite some time. And I am very happy to announce that I have chosen for this very important position none other than my very good friend, Willie Fox.
You mean that?
Put it in the contract.
People around here. Where's the Foreign Legion? Where's the Bedouins?
They're not here yet, sir.
Why?
Colin wants to see you in his office.
All right, hold everything.
Look here, Chief, I got a big set. Where are all the people? What's wrong?
I'm sorry, but I don't think we're going to shoot that fellow.
Not shoot it, why? It's the big kick in the picture. What's the matter?
He's quite frank. We're just a little short.
What do you mean?
I mean, the bankroll
is
no more.
Oh, so that's it. You almost had me fooled. I thought maybe you were going to give Bob and Sook a run for their money.
Really? That's just me. Why, I have figures here to show that every cent of the $50,000 has been spent legitimately.
Yeah, I know. $2,500 for a story?
No, Willie. No. $5,000 for a story.
That's it.
$5,000 for supervision.
That's you?
Correct. $5,000 for a box office name.
That's Van Norton?
Correct. $15,000 for studio rental, $10,000 for set, $6,000 for labor, and the balance, interest?
That's me.
Well, in a way, no. So I felt that you'd be amply repaid by this marvelous opportunity.
Marvelous opportunity to discover how big a crook you are. Why, you never intended to finish this picture. You're just going to take a couple of chumps for a buggy ride, but you made one mistake, Mr. Holland. You thought I was a mug.
Really? Can it be possible I was wrong?
I'll bet you had a lot of laughs letting me direct this picture. Think I'm like your
craving. My fault.
I'll use it. Hello, Bob. Mr. Bob, get a hold of Bob and come down to see you right away. And get Frisk and the Agatha, if she'll come. I can't explain now, Mother. Get down here right away. Hurry. All right, Mr. Flicker. Come out and sit and watch my smoke. I was engaged to direct this picture, and I'm going to finish it in spite of you and your incident.
Good luck. The cruise time is up at 5 o'clock.
That's long enough for me, and from now on, you keep out of my way. One of these days, Mr. Holland, you're going to have the pleasure of rubbing your big nose up against my fist.
What a determined young man.
Folks, we only have a few hours to make this scene, but I've explained it to you, so it's up to you. Now, you all remember where Eustace and Molly are fleeing across the desert, pursued by the Bedouin.
Yes.
The Foreign Legion comes to the rescue.
Yes, I remember, Mr. Pinnacle, reading that.
That's it, Mom, except we have no Bedouins and no Foreign Legion. I'm sure if you people all help me out, we can get along without them.
What do you say?
Yes, of course.
Well, we'll do the best we can. Van Norton, you and Helen enter over that sand dune there.
All right.
Mom, you and Sliskin, you be the Foreign Legion. Now, you stand right over here. Over here, Mom. That's right. Oh, Mr. Sliskin, you know the kind of a noise a camel makes when he runs? No, but I can do a pretty good horse. All right, let me hear your horse run. In the mud? Anywhere, in the sand, in the desert.
How about you, Mom?
You mean like this?
Ah, that's great, Mama. Let me hear them both together. Ah, it's a Foreign Legion! Eustace? Oh, boys. Officer, give your director a break, will you? You and Molly, you're all in. You look back. You see the Bedouins coming.
Oh, that's enough of that.
Stop it.
Whoa.
All right, come on, let's try one. All right, Eustace. Come on, Molly. Bag her on. All right, look back. See the Bedouins coming. Grab her, Eustace. That's it. Good. Read your speech.
I've forgotten it.
We're all set to go, and you forget your speech. The Bedouins are coming. I've got to kill you, darling, you mug. All right, come on, once again. All right, you see them?
The Bedouins are coming.
I've got to kill you, darling. You mug. Oh,
no, no, you're a mug. Don't say it. Oh, I grab him, Molly, when he says that. Be brutal to her, Eustace. No, no, be brutal. Brutal! Put her to her knees. Hang out your saber. Molly. Molly, bare your throat. No, 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 not too much. She'll teach little children to steal. Then the choir leader comes galloping on. All right, let's go. Get ready. How's that for sound?
Okay, a little stronger on the feather ones.
Let's make it. Camera's all set. Sound ready? Light. This is the picture. Quiet, everybody. This is the picture.
The pet ones are coming. I've got to kill you, darling. Hurry together.
Something in this climate that makes fools out of sensible people.
She's gone.
Who's gone?
Agatha. She's been out all night and gone all day. And it's Willie's fault. And if I don't fill his back full of buckshot, it's my fault.
Well, why blame Willie?
Her bed ain't been slept in.
Well, what's Willie got to do with that? If your girl went away with my Willie, that's her fault.
Don't take it so hard.
Try and be calm.
Picking on Willie.
If you'd bought that bomb, we wouldn't be in all this trouble. Have you heard anything about the picture?
No.
But, Bob...
Now, don't worry. Don't worry. We'll pull out all right.
Darling, you've been so sweet. You haven't said an unkind word to
no,
me.
No, I'm not going to. We'll start all over again. By the way, dear, I'll have to borrow your bracelets.
What?
Rope. A little in debt. I'll have to sell them to pay our fare to North.
Oh, Bob!
$15.
I know. He's letting me need some money to put over a great deal.
Yeah, a great deal of who?
Seen a marvelous specimen of the American mammal known as sucker. Hamilton D. Holland speaking.
Maya, out of the Monarch Picture Corporation.
Yes, Mr. Maya.
Yeah, your director, Barton, made some changes to that picture. And it looks pretty good. Now, I'd like to make a deal with you.
Goodbye. Well, I don't know that I'd be able to sell outright, but I'll be in your office late this afternoon. Yes. Yes, goodbye. Boy, Meyer wants to buy the picture. Has that kid put something over on me? And I said something about a sucker. I'm here to make you a proposition.
If you and your gang think you're going to get any more money out of me, you're crazy. I'm broke.
Oh, I'm not here to get any money from you. I'm here to give you some.
What?
I've decided to stand part of your loss. Oh, I should have known better than to let Willie direct that picture.
Don't mention his name to me again.
Sit down, Mr. Now, you lost $40,000. And I feel obligated to stand my share of it. I have here a certified check for $10,000.
$10,000? For me?
Right. And just to keep everything on a business basis, would you mind signing this?
Let me understand this. You're willing to take my share of the picture off my hands for $10,000. Are you sure you can afford it?
I guess it won't cripple me. Besides, it relieves my conscience.
That's a funny thing. I've been over the studio all day looking for you. Loving my eye, too. Now you come here of your own accord and offer me $10,000. I suppose with your knowledge of the business, you'll be able to salvage something.
Not a cent, Mr.
Bennett. A cent? Not
take the money.
But Mr. Bent, I...
Well, it wouldn't be right.
But if I'm willing to...
Now, see here, I rented in this thing with my eyes open. It's up to me to take my medicine. Now, if Willie'd known anything about directing, we'd have made money. Now, that's true, isn't it?
Yes, of course. He burned us. But I want to do the right thing by you, Mr. Bent. You know that, don't you?
Yes, but...
There ain't no buts about it. You sit down, sign that contract, and take that money.
Well, how about Mr. Sliscom?
I'll take care of Mr. Sliscom just as soon as our business is completed.
In that case, of course.
Oh, I didn't know we had company.
How do you do, Mrs. Beck?
Good evening, great, honey. Mr. Holland is going to buy my share of the picture for $10,000.
$10,000?
Yes, I thought it only fair.
Well, I'll say it's fair.
Oh, there's a bottle of it right in the kitchen. I'll get it. Oh, wow! Reggie! Barbara, get this dog's flower! Then take Bob, find that thing, and go buy a farm.
That's exactly what I'm going to do.
There's a sign right here, Mr. Bent.
Just a minute. What's going on here? Howdy, Jesse James. I thought I was a pretty smart fellow, but compared to you, I'm just a boob.
I don't know what you mean.
It never occurred to me you'd pull this trick, but I guess the Marines have landed. Why don't you give yourself up?
Say, now, look here. You've made trouble enough. Mr. Holland is giving me $10,000.
Relax.
Well,
you see, it's like this. Don't start to oil me. Just get out of here.
I'm here on business.
And I'm here to mess it up.
You can't clear any deal for me.
Let's talk this over.
Take it easy, everybody. Mr. Holland and I have a little unfinished business.
Don't you realize that $10,000 is walking right out of this house?
Here's the one I promised.
Oh, Willie!
Are you hurt?
He never even touched me.
If you cleared my deal with Holland,
I'm afraid. I have, I hope.
Boy, you young
don't you dare lay a finger on him.
Yeah, Mother.
There's trouble in the garden. There's a body in the fish pond.
Drag him under the lily.
Where are you going?
To get my gun.
No, you're not. You're going to stay right here. Mother!
You shut up, too. If my boy's in trouble, it's all your fault.
Willie, have you done anything to Agatha?
Yes.
Oh, he married me. Oh.
What?
My boy.
I'm going to tell Holland that I'm not responsible.
Now, Bob, wait a minute. I have here a contract from the Monarch Picture Corporation.
What?
For an alleged drama called Scorching Passion.
Oh, it's not a drama. It's a comedy.
In addition, I have a check for $10,000 on account. The balance of $80,000 agreed upon.
$80,000
will be paid when you and you sign this contract.
Well, Willie, how did you do all this?
Tell him about me, honey.
He bought house cutting.
And I had all that fun, didn't cost you anything.
Well, I don't know. He got me for a son-in-law.
Oh, boy, we didn't get that nut farm after all. Now you can come and live with it.
Well, that's up to Ma. The 45% that I bought from Holland belongs to Ma.
Oh, I can't take it. What can you do?
Oh, don't worry about us. Willie signed a contract to direct Maya at $750 a week.
You should have held out for $750 a week. $250 ain't enough.